Hey guys, it is Sunday the 21st of May 2017. I'm having a chilled day today after 2 days in London and heading into Brighton, heading to the train station now. Gonna do some wandering about, have a look in some bookshops, do some reading, catch some Pokemon. And I just fancy vlogging, so let's go catch a train to Brighton.
You're watching Newcomes.
That is so cool. I love it. So I got into Brighton and discovered that there is a lava tower nearby in a road that I hadn't been down before, full of awesome graffiti. I mean, look at the grumpy monkey. That's so cool. One of the things I love about Brighton is how much like cool graffiti they've got. Look at this. What? I haven't seen all this before. So cool. Wow. That is just incredible. That would have been too if someone hadn't tagged all over it. That's a shame. As always, it wouldn't be me coming into Brighton without going to have a look in Waterstones at the books. I've also just seen my friend Morgan, who's about to start busking nearby, so I might film a little bit of him when I come out. I'm already finding more books like that one that I want to buy. No. Gotta love a good book. Oh my god, those are amazing.
What?
Right, done some looking in the shops and in the lanes. Time to get some lunch. Yeah, I'm going to Subway. Where else? It's such a nice warm day that I'm actually going to a little park by the i360 and sit and read for a bit while I charge my phone up. Some walking on the beach and catching Pokemon. I've come down to the Brighton Donut. This is a pretty good place for Pokemon, especially when there's lots of people around. Right, I've now come onto the pier to do some more Pokemon hunting.
Guard over your way. And guess what?
So I've just crossed over from the pier, and there's a load of people walking along singing Kylie. I don't know what's going on, but it's funny. Oh god, and they're coming this way. They're behind me! I've no idea. I have no idea what that was, but they all had Beats wireless headphones on. We're all listening to the same song. I know this due to the fact that one guy took his Beats wireless earphones off and put them on my ears. And they all went into a bar, so it's probably some sort of bar event, I guess. It was at least funny to watch. Very funny. I just caught another Aerodactyl in Pokemon Go. I'm very happy with that. Now I'm going to head towards the train station. Okay, so I take part of that back. They went near a bar and I thought they'd gone in, but they didn't go in because I just caught up with them. They're still walking about singing. Well, I'm home. I had a nice afternoon slash few hours in Brighton, just catching Pokemon, just getting out and getting a bit of sunshine, looking around the shops. Thought I'd do a little book update. So, I have finished Release by Patrick Ness. This is all about a guy called Adam Thorne, and it's a day in his life, and it's all about this very, very sort of manic day where lots and lots of things happen. I don't really know how to describe it well. It's a coming out story, as Adam is gay, and his parents are very, very religious, and it was really good. I gave it a 4 out of 5, I think, on Goodreads. It was good, but I don't know, something about it, just it wasn't as gripping as some of the other novels that Patrick Ness has done, but I did enjoy it. I'm now reading The Finding of Martha Lost by Caroline Wallace. Caroline Wallace is actually now Caroline Smales, but this is published in her maiden name. And Caroline Smales is the author of The Drowning of Arthur Braxton. So this is all about a girl called Martha. And she is, what do you know, lost. She was left in Liverpool Lime Street train station as a baby, taken in by this woman who runs the lost property, and it's all about what happens in her life. I'm a fair chunk in. I've been trying to read this because Lord of Shadows by Cassandra Clare comes out next week, and I was powering through this. It's not the sort of book I'd normally read, probably due to the fact that it's based like in 1976, before I was born. And I don't know, it's not really the sort of story I'd normally read, but I am really enjoying it. It's really, really good. It's all about Martha, obviously, and how her sort of mother, the woman that took her in, ran her life. And she told her that she was Liverpool Lime Street's liver bird, meaning that if Martha left the station would fall down. And it's all about what happens with Martha and all these different things. And so far, I'm really enjoying it. I will give a proper review at some point soon when I finished it. But yeah, so far, I'm really enjoying this and I would recommend it. And it's just come out on paperback. So yeah, really good book so far. So that's a little bookish update. I hope you've enjoyed this weekend's videos. This will be the third video that's gone up, although this probably won't be up till Monday morning now, but oh well. Next week, I'm going up to London for Comic-Con. I am there all 3 days, Friday, Saturday and Sunday. So if you're going to Comic-Con, let me know down there in the comments below, and maybe we'll be able to see each other and meet up. Who knows? I'm going to be vlogging each day. I'm going to be vlogging with cosplayers. So, as last year I got told, oh, you say the same boring old questions all the time. If anyone has any cosplayer questions that I can ask different people, leave them down in the description, because that would be awesome to have some sort of different questions to ask them. But yeah. Hope you enjoyed this video. If you did, give it a thumbs up, and I will see you soon. Bye, guys.